Support for KQED Live comes from Berkeley Rep and the San Francisco Symphony.
Impact of
more than half of black business owners.
And disproportionately.
Somehow we always find a way to rise.
To the blueprint builders, to the backbones of every block, for the curators of the culture, and for generations to follow. You might fall, but never fail. Keep rising. Keep rising. Keep rising. Apply for business, marketing, and tech makeovers on us.
Good evening, everyone. Hey, woo! My name is Esperanza Vaquiz, and I am the KQED Live intern. For those of you joining us for the first time, welcome. KQED is Northern California's NPR PBS member station. KQED Live is our multi-platform events program that produces screenings, talks, performances, and food tastings based on KQED's mission to inform, inspire, and involve. You can learn more about all of that at kqed.org/live. If we bring value to your everyday life, and I hope we do, I encourage you to become a KQED member. You can find out about how at kqed.org/donate. We want to thank the season sponsors that make KQED Live possible: SF MoMA, Berkeley Rep, Comcast Business, and San Francisco Symphony. We also wanted to shout out our community partners for bringing us all together. Be prepared for this list. All right. The 2024 Fresh Festival runs from February 9th to 18th across historic stages and outdoor spaces in San Francisco. Experience 9 days of experimental performances, drag, parties, and community events. Visit www.freshfestival.org for tickets and info. Join the African American Arts and Culture Complex this Saturday, February 10th, for a symposium of Preserving Black Art. Follow at AAA Culture Complex on Instagram for details. And a huge thank you to Ray Studios. 3 lucky winners from our audience will receive complimentary dance classes. Check your inboxes to see if you've won. Explore more of their offerings at www.raystudios-sf.com. Now, tonight's host is Traci Bartlow, a KQED star. She is a dance instructor, culture maker, dance archivist, and photographer, an expert in documenting and preserving Black dance. Traci has been featured in the KQED series, If Cities Could Dance, and has done 2 previous events with us. She also runs Be Love's Guest House, a boutique hotel in West Oakland, California, with an art gallery and urban garden. As the owner and operator, this guest house is based on her holistic lifestyle of wellness and creativity. Please give a warm welcome to Traci. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. Welcome to KQED Live. I am your host, Traci Bartlow. Thank you for this opportunity. I thank you for this opportunity to share my passion of documenting and preserving Black dance and culture. Tonight, we are going to have a dance party. And we're going to move through different eras of the Black dance experience. I curated three eras to share with you. And these eras come from the perspective of coming of age, when you're a teenager, moving into your adult years. So I'm looking at the coming of age story of my grandparents from the 1920s and 30s. And then I'm going to my parents' coming of age with rhythm and blues from the 1950s and the 1960s. And then finally, my own coming of age story from the 1970s and 80s. Now, this is a participatory experience. It's a party, y'all. And so the party's going to go down like this. I'll talk a little bit about the era. I'll show you some dance steps. You'll come out on the dance floor. I'll show you some dance steps, and then we'll practice them to music. So we'll go through different eras like that. A little talking, show you some dance steps, practice it to music. And at the end, I'm just gonna play some music. You all can fill up on the dance floor and just dance and party and celebrate Black History Month. So the first era is the jazz age, the 1920s and the Harlem Renaissance. This era was very special for African American people as there was a shift that was happening. The shift was the Great Migration, where African Americans were leaving these oppressive conditions in the South and moving to northern cities like Chicago and New York to find a better life and in hopes of more opportunities. So when I look at the dances from this era, they feel like liberation to me. So if you think about having this opportunity to be fully actualized, an opportunity to use your God-given talent and skill and take it as far as you possibly could go, and how this shift in consciousness brought about a new self-awareness and self-love and empowerment. And so all of this energy of this shift and this newfound self-love and empowerment, baby, it comes out in the dances, and honey, they were feeling liberation. So I would like to invite you all to come out on the dance floor. I love the way this room is set up. Yes, please, come on out. I love the way the room is set up because you can sit down and watch, or you can get up and dance. So if you ever get tired and you want to just sit and watch, you're welcome to just sit and watch. So here are some of the party dances from the 1920s. It's so good to see so many people here, so many folks in the house. So the first dance we're going to do is called Boogie Back. And it goes like this. When you boogie up, I like your hands to be in the air and your hips kind of go from side to side. Hey. And I love it has this little sway, like you don't have a care in the world. Sometimes I boogie back with a little jump like this. Yes. You can also boogie up with a cool walk. Step. Step, step, Step. Yes. Yes. Ooh, I'm feeling that. Okay. You are giving me a cool walk. And what's really incredible is that the term cool was coined during the Harlem Renaissance. So, baby, if you think about being cold as ice, yes, it's all about that swag and that vibe. The next dance I would like to share with you is called the Mess Around. So, the Mess Around, you're gonna have some space between your feet, and I like for you to just bend your knees and do a nice, easy bounce. So let's see if we could bounce together, like bounce, 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 bounce. Yes. Oh, I'm feeling the room is bouncing, yes. And then you're gonna take your bounce and make a circle. Bounce and make a circle. That's the Mess Around. Hey, yes. You can even reverse other way. Bounce, bounce, yes. Bounce, 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 bounce. Beautiful. So another step is the Shorty George. And it's named after an actual person who was less than 5 feet tall. George Snowden. He was a very famous dancer in the 1920s. And his dance, okay, the comedy is he would make himself look shorter by going like this. So the Shorty George, you're gonna make like this diagonal with your arms and your shoulders and your knees, and you just go in different directions. Yes. You can also walk with the Shorty George like this. Yes, I love how you all are using the space. This is awesome. So another dance that was named after a person is called the Tacky Annie. And they say Tacky Annie was a showgirl. And you know how when the line is going off the stage and then that last person on stage, they may hit a little move before they go into the curtains. This is the move that she did. Yes, nice, Let's try it again, let's all go to your right. Step, touch, 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 step, touch. Awesome. Now, there's a little something that goes with the Tacky Annie, and it happens on the count and eight. And what you'll do is you'll step and eight. So if I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Nice. So after the and date, then you take this step. Okay? Let's try it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Touch, touch. 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Let's see, I'm gonna go and eight, touch, two, four, five, six, seven, and eight, touch, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Okay, let's do that to music. We'll take it nice and easy to start. Then we'll speed it up. We're gonna start with the boogie back. Here we go. be back. With the boogie bag. Yes. Take your cool walk forward. Uh-huh. Mess around. Hey. Oh, other way. Circle. Yes, good. Hey. Let's start with the tacky, Annie. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2. Good. Now let's do the rock. 5, 6, 7, 8. Rock. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Very nice. And now, the shorty, George. 1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's take it up. And boogie back. Boogie up. Mess around. Yes. Other way. Tacky Annie. Beautiful. A new step. You're gonna make a circle with your knees. Yes. You can go to your right. Yes. Yes. Boogie up. Boogie up. I love it. Boogie back. Mess around. Hey. Nice. I love it. There is some really good energy in this room. So, when you think about this new shift in consciousness that Black folks had, this sense of self, self-love, an opportunity for a different kind of success, there was a term that they gave themselves, a few of the artists in Freedom Fighters in Harlem, they called themselves the new Negro. Okay? The new Negro. And it really speaks to this different kind of way of thinking, like, I'm coming brand new. There's something new and something better that I want in my life. So here is a picture of my grandfather in his coming of age years, Frank Bell. He was a farmer. And when it was time for him to go out and dance, this is the way he chose to dress. That hat, that jacket. I mean, is that like a jacket on top of something else, a button down? And not just his clothes, but look at his pose. And look at the intent in his eyes and the gaze that gives you this feeling of a new Negro. So my grandfather was known as a good dancer and the life of the party. And his dance was this one, the ball and the jack. Okay, so we're gonna practice the ball and the jack. It's just a circle with your knees. There's a few different variations of it, but for today, we're just gonna do some real basic steps. Okay? So we did the boogie up, boogie back, mess around, Shorty George, Tacky Annie. Here's a few more steps that we'll do to music. The Charleston. The Charleston started in Harlem, New York City in the 1920s, or actually maybe a little bit before, maybe 1918, 17. But by the 1920s, the Roaring Twenties, the Charleston was the first international dance craze. People in countries all over the world dance the Charleston. And the basics of the Charleston is just front and back. Front and back. Try it with me. Front, yes, and back, yes. Front and back. Very good. Front and back. Step front. And back, right leg, front, left leg, back. Yes, front and back. Front and back, yes, front and back. Now you can get a little fancy with it, and a variation is just to twist your feet. Front and back. You can either do it with the little twist of your feet, or you could do it straight. So you can go front, back, front, back, or you can go twist and back, front, yes, front and back, front and back, yes. Now, if you're feeling a little ambitious, you can touch the floor, kick, touch the floor, kick, touch the floor. Okay, I'll do this for the people that want to be a little adventurous, kick, and touch the floor, kick, and touch the floor. The next step is called fall off the log. And it goes, it feels in that direction. So the rhythm of the step is kick, step, step, step. 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 Back. Back. Do, do, do. Back. Do, do, back. Do, do, back. Do, do. Okay. That. 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 Do, do, do. That. Do, do, do. That. Nice. The last step that we'll do is the applejack. Now, the applejack is a little complex, so I'm going to show you a very easy version of it. Basically, the way it actually looks is the feet are twisting like this. But I find that it's just as fun when doing it for the first time or when just practicing it as a new step, just to hold the rhythm. And the rhythm is da, 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 da. Ba, 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 ba. Yes, da, 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 da. Yes, and so what happens is you do a little da, 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 da. Da da ba 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 da 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 da. Okay? All right, now let's put it all together. We're gonna go through all of these steps and we'll do it to a faster song. We're gonna start with the ball in the jack. So do one and two fast. Slow, fast, slow, fast, slow. Let's boogie back. Good job, everyone. Also from the 1920s is the Lindy Hop innovation. It started at the Savoy Ballroom in Harlem. And Lindy Hop is the original term for swing dance. And what's incredible is this is a dance that happened 100 years ago. And even today, there's swing dance in Lindy Hop communities in major cities worldwide, even in some remote places. Here in the Bay Area, there is a long-standing tradition of swing dance, weekly events, competitions, dance conferences, as well as in these major cities and communities worldwide. Somebody is having a weekly party, a dance conference, an annual conference, and even competitions and battles. I personally have been to Lindy Hop events in Seattle, Texas, DC area, New York, Montreal. I know swing dancers in Mozambique, in Brazil, in Japan, in London. It is an international thing that is still happening today. And it began in the 1920s in Harlem, New York City. Now, I'm gonna share with you two of the pioneers from Lindy Hop. First is George Snowden, Shorty George. He was in the first generation of Lindy Hoppers. There's a video clip that we'll play later, and it's Shorty George with his partner, Big B. If he was like barely 5 feet, she was like 5'11". And they danced very well together. So first generation Lindy Hoppers was Shorty George is one of the pioneers. And the other generation is this man with that big old smile, Frankie Manning. And Frankie Manning, his innovations in Lindy Hop are the air steps. So you see how he's throwing the girl over his back? It looks like they're landing out of a air step. Frankie Manning is the person that took it to the air. And there's an incredible scene that you can find on YouTube from a film called Hell's a Poppin'. And it's shared a lot online. And baby, they are dancing Lindy Hop at a high, fast pace and high flying in the air. We're not gonna do any of that today. We're just gonna do the basics of a swing out, a basic swing out. And the rhythm is step, step, triple step, 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 triple step. One, two, 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 triple step, 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 triple step. So whatever you do, keep that rhythm with your feet. And I would like for, this is a partner dance. So I would like for you to find a partner and come out on the floor. Kwai, can you assist me with this? Unless Janelle wants to. Okay, so you can move forward. Can some people move forward so you have a little more space on the floor? So face your partner. And the partner on my side, you will be a lead. The partner on Kwai's side will be the follow. The people on my side, you will dance on your left, and the people on this side will start on your right. So let me just set this down. You ask your partner to dance with your left hand. They put their right in your left. And you're going to do what's called a rock step on that 1-2. So you go one, so you go back. 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. So when you come in for the triple step, I'm gonna put my hand on her waist, and her hand is going to be on my shoulder. So we go 1-2, triple step, 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 and stay together. Then come apart and together. Step, step, triple step. 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. Now, with this right hand that's on her waist, this hand, you're going to guide her. And for now, we're just going to do a half circle. And then again, back to where you started. Yes, let's try that again. This hand is on her waist. You're going to pull her around to a half circle. And then once again, into another half circle. So I'd like for you to just watch. We're gonna go 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. Okay, let's try that. 1-2, here we go. 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. 1-2, triple step, step, step. Triple again. 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. 1-2, triple step, 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 triple step. Fantastic. Now, we're going to do a full circle now. And just watch. One, two, triple step, 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 triple step. One, two, triple step, step, step. Let me do it again. One, two, triple step, 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 triple step. Let's try it together, everyone. One, two, here we go. One, two, triple step, 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 triple step. Just make a circle. One, two, triple step. Let's try it again. Five, six, here we go. One, two, triple step, 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 trip again. One, two, triple step, 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 triple step. All right. How you feeling? You feeling good? Yes, yes, yes. So understand that this is the very, very basic of it. And there's a lot of nuances that I just don't have time to share tonight, but I just wanted to give you a feel of what that's like. So we're going to try it to music. So let's put a little drill together. We'll do two in place, two half turns, and two full turns. So it'll look like this. In place, da 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 da, di di da, ba ba, be ba ba, ba 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 ba, boom ba, da 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 da, do da 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 da, ba 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 ba, do da 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 da, do da 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 da. Okay. So I'll put on a song that's a little slow. Before we start, I'm just gonna sing the rhythm. Listen. Da, 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 da. Step, step, triple step, 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 triple step. Yes. Step, triple step, 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 triple step, 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 triple step, step, step. Very good, yes. All right. Offer your partner your hand, and now let's go. Two in place. Where you going? On my shoulder. Two half turns. This out. Boogie back. Boogie up. Boogie back. Boogie up. Boogie back. Now let's do the drill again. One, two, triple step, 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 triple step. One, two, triple step on my shoulder. Half turn. Full turn. Boogie back. Boogie back. Boogie up. Do the ball in the jack. Boogie back. Boogie up. Boogie back. Shorty George going up. Mess around. Offer your partner your hand. Let's do the drill. One, two, triple step. One, two.
two.
Half turn. Half turn. Full turn. Boogie back. Mess around. Hey. Other way. Techie Annie. Can you get my tea from the room? You can just put it up here. Show yourself some love. Moving on through time. Let's go into the next era. Both of my parents were born in 1940. So by the 1950s and 60s, they were teenagers and young adults. My father was born here in the Bay Area, and my mother was born in Texas. The picture you saw earlier was her father. Story goes, around 1959, my mother was barely 20 years old. And actually, my parents, my mother's family moved from Texas to San Luis Obispo, California. And the story goes, around 1959, my mother, barely 20 years old, along with her older sister, my Aunt Louise, they would take the Amtrak train from San Luis Obispo up to Oakland, get off at the 16th Street station, and experience the nightclubs like Slim Jenkins Supper Club and the Continental. There were cousins and other family friends that also lived in the area, and they would also frequent clubs in Berkeley and San Francisco. Now, my parents, this is a picture of my parents in 1964, all dressed up, and then this is another picture of my parents in 2002. So they met at San Pablo Park in Berkeley. Dated, fell in love, and found that they shared a love of music and dance. So I'm going to share with you some of the dances that I saw as a child that were the party dances that my parents did in the 1950s and the 1960s. Okay, twine time. That was the dance. Sometimes people call it twine, the twine, but there's a song called Twine Time. And twine goes like this. I like the twine because you can also go down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Now, the Madison is a line dance, and it's a whole routine. But the very first step of the Madison is kind of like the twine, down, up, and then you cross, cross. So it goes down, cross, cross. Let me count it off right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, the Madison. There was the jerk. Ah, 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 ah. I have to pause for a moment. It is so wonderful seeing elderly people be like, yeah, that was my step. I'm feeling you. It's so beautiful to see people have this memory of like, yeah, these were the dances that we did in our day. So the jerk has a nice, fun little snap to it. You can jerk. And even go side to side. You can even jerk with a little circle. There's the twist. The twist. You can go low. You can come up on one leg. You can twist to the other side. Come up on that one leg. Also, a variation of the twist is you can make a circle with your hips this way. And you can go, so let's say if you went slow, two, three, four, then you can go faster. And then in the go-go days, they would go triple time. So if you're feeling inspired, you can pick it up. So the twist, and the pony. One, two, three, 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 one, two, three. The Watusi is a nice little shake of the hips. And it also kind of looks like the swim. And the backstroke. I'm loving all the smiles I'm seeing. And then there's the deep dive. The monkey. And the mashed potatoes, which kind of looks like the Charleston. So let's try all these dances from the 1950s and the 1960s with the hit song, Twine Time. Can you play that from the booth, please?
It's twine time. Ooh, ah, ooh, ah.
Down and up. And the jerk. Deep dive. Nice. I'm going to wet my whistle. Before we go to the next era, let's do all those dances to a faster song. Can you play Come On and Swim from the booth? All right, get ready.
Come on in. Bobby's gonna show you how to do the swim.
Yes. Hey, take it down.
Kinda like the monkey. Do the swim, baby, now work it on out. Now, baby, swim.
Twist.
Baby, do the swim.
Pony.
Do what you wanna. It's all right. Cause Bobby's gonna show you how to swim tonight.
Watusi.
Now, baby, swim.
Swim.
Come on, baby. I want you to swim.
Well, yeah, I see y'all in the back.
Battle, now do the backstroke.
Backstroke.
Oh, yeah. Kind of like the monkey, kind of like the twist. Pretend you're in the water and you go like this. Now, baby, swim. Baby, do the swim.
Let's do the twist one more time.
Just like the dog, but not so low. Like the hully gully, but not so slow. Now, baby, swim.
Pony.
Baby, do the swim.
Now, let's just
do what you wanna. I do
swim.
What you wish. Come on, baby, now and swim like a fish. Now, baby, swim. Baby, come on in. Shake it up, baby. Twist and shout. I do the swim, baby, now work it on out. Now, baby, swim. Baby, do the swim. Do what you want.
Oh, for sure.
It's all right. Cause Bobby's gonna do the swim for you tonight. Now, baby, swim.
Deep dive all the way down. Ooh, thank you, thank you. I am feeling your energy. Y'all are really doing it. All right, we have one more era to explore. This is my coming of age. P-Funk, Funkadelic, James Brown. Now, I was born in 1965. And there were things happening in America socially. It was actually another shift that was happening in the 1960s. Sometimes they were referred to as the Red Summer because there were uprisings and protests that were happening, usually as a result or it came to a head with some police brutality case. But baby, let me tell you, America was on fire. There were uprisings in Watts, Chicago, New York, Newark. In 1968, when Dr. King was assassinated, there were riots and protests, uprisings all over the country. So these are things that were happening in the background while I was a toddler, while I was a child. And even though my parents did their best to shield me and my siblings from what was happening, I feel like the spirit of revolution is just embedded in my psyche. And it is present in the work that I do even today. So this era of the 70s, you know, it came out of this, you know, the funk revolution. You know, it was a change in music. And funk had a more grittier sound than rhythm and blues and soul. And the 70s also brought about the birth of hip hop. So I'd like to share with you some of the dances that I did as a child. And I'm actually going to cue up my song before I show you some steps. The first dance that we're going to do is the breakdown. Hey, and the breakdown looks like this. Yes. Da, 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 da. You have the four corners. This is called the funky robot. While I'm facing this way, I'm going to do the four corners. You also have the bump. And if you have your partner close by, your hips touch. Bump, yes. So you can go bump, and then the other side. Bump your partner, the other side. Yeah! Y'all better get it. Come on, y'all better get it right down in the front. Camel walk. So we'll try those to music. This is one of my favorite songs by Curtis Mayfield. This came out in 1971, and this song is called Get Down. Let them know. Yeah. Oh, I feel this. Four corners. Hey, that's right. Let's do the bump. Camel walk.
To the funky, funky, funky groove. Get down, baby. Let the light reflect upon your natural mood.
Actually,
get down, baby.
This was in 1971. I'm sure somebody was still doing the jerk.
Get down, baby. After life and desire, there was nothing left.
Back to the breakdown. We're all children of this world.
A hungry man in search for a hungry girl. The extreme supreme of all cannibals.
Four corners.
The most weighty and cheap thing of all the land. Get down. Get down.
Camel walk. All right. Very good. I would like to do just a few more steps because we are moving on in time as well. Now, the birth of hip hop, 1970s. As you all know, we are now celebrating the 50th anniversary of hip hop. 1973, Bronx, New York. There was a legendary house party that set it off. People are now starting to understand that there are some innovations to hip hop culture that happened in California. Okay? So, New York has the DJing, graffiti, rapping, beatboxing, and when it comes to dance, they have the top rock, or what they call rocking, and onto the floor with the floor work and the spins and all the stunts and breakdancing. But when it comes to boogaloo, that's Oakland. Roboting, they call them Richmond robots. There's even a style from San Francisco called strutting. From Los Angeles, you got locking. And Fresno, California. What? You have from Fresno, California, one of the pioneers of popping, Boogaloo Sam, and the leader of the Electric Boogaloos. So from Northern California to Southern California, these are all innovations in the foundation of hip hop dance that started in our beautiful, lovely state. So I'm gonna show you some of these early hip hop moves, just a few of them. Worming, which is like these waves. You also see it in different kinds of boogaloo illusions. And then there's the creeping. So I want you to think about, this is also part of like boogaloo popping and what the Oakland cats call bamming, because they tense up their muscles and they make these hits. So it's like bam, 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 bam. So it's like you tense up your muscles and you make this sharp staccato move. Bam, 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 bam. You can also take the creep. So this is what we'll do with creeping. You'll step forward and together, step forward and together, step forward and together, step forward and together. But you do it in a very staccato way like this. Bam, 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 bam. When you go back, you kind of double it up like this. Bam. So then there's locking. It was made famous by Rerun, a character on a sitcom called What's Happening. And Rerun was one of the original members of the Lockers. And this form of locking comes from a man named Don Campbell. And he was living in LA and a Soul Train dancer at the time. And they even called this Campbell locking. So we'll do some of these steps to, can you play from the booth, Mr. Groove?
Please, Mr. Groove.
We're gonna take it to the 80s. Just step to the side. Let's just get into this groove right here. Hey, I see you feeling it. Let's do the creep forward. Yes. Take it back. Step to the side. Very good. Nice. Thank you, DJ. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Soundman in the booth. So, now we have a little time to just dance. You can have a seat and watch the dance floor. You can come out on the dance floor and do your thing. I'm gonna play a few songs. And there's also gonna be some really cool videos to watch. So thank you for the instruction part of the class. Let's dance a little bit. I'm going to go in the order that the class happened, so we'll start with some jazz. We're going to start with some Count Basie, Swinging the Blues.